You know how you find a dank meme and it goes straight to your friend's group chat? Same thing here, but it's an app development version. I just want to nerd out over some cool GPT-4 use cases. No lecturing, no tips. Just some cool shit people are doing with GPT-4 that makes me go, damn, I wish I'd thought about that. Differences between GPT-3 and GPT-4. We've seen some amazing apps and SaaS that leverage GPT-3 and 3.5. Now, GPT-4 is out, and it's everything GPT-3 is, but better. As great as GPT-3 is, it only works off of 175 billion parameters. Only. Parameters here means the number of biases it uses to understand input and generate responses. Generally, more points of bias equals better perceptiveness and accuracy. GPT-4 works off of 100 trillion parameters. There are 1,000 billions in a trillion. In theory, that makes GPT-4 a million times more perceptive and capable of connecting the dots. Other upgrades include analyzing and understanding images, answering questions based on image input, and being trained on a larger dataset. All that means more creativity and more factual accuracy, which translates to better problem solving. One downside is it costs significantly more to use compared to GPT-3. It just means you need to find cost-effective ways to use it. And people have found quite a few. I would like to share 7 of those use cases. They're all gonna impress you, but the last one will give you a whole new perspective. So stick around to the end, no skipping. Psst, psst. Help me out and subscribe. Thanks. Back to the video. Editor, play the video. Number 1, Wolverine. My bias as a developer is showing, but damn, this thing is cool. As of now, Wolverine only exists as a Python script that you can find on GitHub. It has 2 USPs. First, the coolest name ever, no contest. Second, it uses GPT-4 to fix Python bugs in freshly written code at runtime and keeps rerunning the code until everything works as intended. It's debugging on steroids. It's being marketed as self-regenerating, just like Wolverine from the comic books. As a concept, this will save developers a ton of time and headache. Freshly written scripts always have bugs. It takes just one missing letter and functions become undefined. If this is a key function, your script will crash. Wolverine runs your script, detects error, asks GPT-4 for solutions, explains what went wrong, makes changes based on GPT-4's input, run the script again, repeating step 2 to 4 until the script is running properly. The example is using a simple script, but great things start simple. Today, it's editing basic stuff. In a year's time, it might be editing entire marketplaces and video games. Reminds me of GitHub Copilot, which makes real-time suggestions. That makes Wolverine GitHub Autopilot, since it does all the work for you. Number 2, Do Not Pay. Do Not Pay calls itself the world's first robot lawyer. A bit strange, aren't all lawyers heartless machines? Do Not Pay helps you save money by integrating GPT-4 and AutoGPT under a chat system within the platform to automate simple legal processes like parking tickets, cancelling, auto-debiting, subscriptions, and seeking refunds. Real quick, AutoGPT is a software that instructs GPT-4 on your behalf. You tell AutoGPT what you want and it continuously prompts GPT-4 until a task is complete. It's gotten a lot of hype lately, so I'm glad to see it out in the real world. GPT-4 and AutoGPT combined can automate the research and the generation of reports, claims, and complaints. You can find a full list of features on their site. I stopped counting after 100. What I really like is a feature called Find Me Money, where Do Not Pay hands down money that you could be entitled to or expenses you're paying unnecessarily. The kind of thing where you can save a couple $100 here and there. Do Not Pay CEO Joshua Browder recently tweeted about how the app saved him $217.85 in 24 hours without him having to do much of anything. He gave it full access to his email, bank accounts, and financial statements, then told the bot, "Find me money." Some of the things Do Not Pay handle include getting a refund from an airline company for a recent flight where Joshua was billed for Wi-Fi but did not receive. Analyze Joshua's transaction for a full list of subscriptions. Speak to a gym to cancel Joshua's gym subscription after getting approval from him. Negotiate with Joshua's telco company, landing him a 100% better deal. All within 24 hours. And all without much effort from Joshua. $200 in a day isn't really worth it when you have to go through the hassle of claiming it. Definitely not worth hiring another person to handle. But do not pay this it at the push of a button for $36 every 2 months. That kind of pricing is clearly aimed at US customers, but point is, it's a great way to hit back at big businesses who have been screwing consumers over with shady practices. Previously, Do Not Pay was using GPT 3.5, but Joshua says it was nowhere near capable of GPT-4's accuracy and ability to reason. I know that Do Not Pay has attracted some controversy and legal threats. I would never advise breaking the law, but notice that they are being sued for not having a law license. But at the same time, GPT-4 was reported by Stanford University to be good enough to pass both the multiple choice and written bar exam. I'm no lawyer, but looks like someone's feeling a little threatened. Like their age-old industry might become obsolete soon. Thing is, the legal profession is outdated all over the world. And Do Not Pay pretty much only covers the US. So if you're not from the US, it sounds like a SaaS idea waiting to happen. Number three, Snoop Stein. We go from stabilizing elitist legal services to something a lot less serious, but still useful. Snoop Stein is a Twitter bot powered by GPT-4. Instructions on how to use him are as easy as setting up IKEA furnitures. Step 1, make a tweet. Step 2, tag Snoop Stein. Step 3, he'll drop some knowledge on you. He's been prompted to reply in the style of world-famous rapper Snoop Dogg, combined with the physicist theory of Albert Einstein. You're probably wondering, how the hell it's useful? Well, the actual use case I want to share is the step-by-step guide by MindsDB on how you can build your own custom GPT-4 Twitter bot and make it answer in the style of Snoop Dogg, Cat Dog, Snoopy the Dog, all up to you. Two very real benefits. As you go through the steps, you'll see it's a pretty fun way to understand and practice making your own machine learning model and connecting it to other apps via API, in this case, Twitter. The real life application I see here is creating social media bots for your company or brand that gives you a unique voice and makes you stand out for the right reasons. Case in point, the official fast food Wendy's Twitter is famous and super popular for roasting, well, everything. I shit you not, they even have their own subreddit with over 20,000 members. A GPT-4 powered bot with your company's Twitter handle can be a low effort, high return solution to charm the internet and raise your brand awareness. Or you can use it for high quality shit posting, the choice is yours. The next example is also a GPT-4 powered bot, but specifically for excellent customer service. Number 4, watermelon. Every time I hear watermelon, I think of Harry Styles. Every time I think of Harry Styles, I question my sexuality. I don't know why I just told you that, let's move on. Watermelon is a collection of a few different products, but we're looking at their GPT-4 solution. They've built Pulse, a super simple and user-friendly interface for businesses to build their own personalized chatbot powered by GPT-4 and train on their business specifics. You can teach the bot what your business is about, services and promotions you offer, what kind of tone and language the bot should reply in, keywords from customers that trigger certain actions. And remember, there is a machine learning model behind all this. So you can train the bot even further by testing it and providing feedback on how to improve. Finally, this chatbot has automatic integration with WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, and your website, all with zero coding. Check out Watermelon's customer case study page and you'll see that they've really got something good going on here. Not only will you never have to worry that customers get late replies, the instant replies are of high quality and it sounds like someone is talking back to you rather than a bot. Unless that's what you tell the chatbot to do. This has so many applications. Whether someone is running a business or a charity or an LMS, it kind of feels like having that paperclip guy from Microsoft Word, but this time actually useful. Speaking of useful, I think the next GPT-4 use case is the most useful one on this list, simply because it has the potential to directly save lives. Number 5, Dragon Ambient Experience Express, DEX. If Wolverine has the best name, this one has the worst. It reeks of corporate speak. But in terms of application, I think it blows everything else on this list out of the water. If I have to use that full name, this video will take weeks. So I'll just call it DEX. And for your information, it's ultimately owned by Microsoft. Dragon is a speech recognition and scribe software integrated with GPT-4. It assists medical professionals by recording real life or online patient consultations and documenting them automatically in an integrated database so those who need to know can be updated immediately. On older versions of Dragon, the notes were manually reviewed before being uploaded into the physician's electronic health records, usually after about 4 hours. With the help of GPT-4's advanced reasoning and natural language capabilities, the notes are now returned in seconds. Of course, the doctor still needs to review the notes and they have the final sign-off. It still means less paperwork for medical staff and more time focusing on patients. Or maybe the extra time doctors and nurses have can now be used for rest. Physicians, burnout is a very real thing and any help they can get, I say, give it to them. If this example helps you once you become a doctor, the next example helps you to become a doctor. And the last example, I don't want to spoil it. Number 6, Elicit. This is going to be the nerdiest entry on this list, but the world needs nerds. And nerds needs Elicit, the AI research assistant. Elicit uses GPT-4 to automate research workflow, like parts of literature review. It can find relevant papers without perfect keyword match, summarize takeaways from a paper specific to your question, and extract key information from papers. Those are its core features, but it can also help with brainstorming and text classification. The founders have a diagram of how it works. You'll notice it relies a lot on various GPT-3 model, not just DaVinci. Now, this SaaS was launched in 2022, and with GPT-3 alone, it was already able to do all that summarizing and extraction. In 2023, they started using GPT-4, and users can take those summaries and extractions and group them based on concept, which should facilitate discovery of more accurate source material. If you've ever done academic research in the past 10 years, you'll know what a pain in the ass it is to use those journals and Google Scholar. So much time is wasted looking for the right source material instead of going through it. So when I see this part of a series of tweets by the creator of Elicit, I was like, damn, these kids will never know how tough we had it in uni. In fact, the entire series of tweets was amazing to read, and looking at the capabilities they plan to add to Elicit, I wouldn't be surprised if Google Scholar and Citation Machine become obsolete in a few years. Amazing use case. The version of Elicit powered by GPT-4 is currently in testing, but if you are a university student or if you know someone who is, sign up for their waitlist. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Drum roll, please. Number 7, Reese GPT. After I was done compiling this list up to number 6, I realized something. It didn't have enough Reese. Everything I'd put together was either about making the world a better place or enhancing customer experience. That's okay, I guess, but it's not gonna get you late. This one just might. Say hello to Reese GPT. It's one of the most unique applications of GPT-4 I've ever seen. If I'm honest, it's probably also one of the dumbest in a good way. I told you number 7 was going to change how you looked at AI applications, right? Well, I meant that literally. Take a look at this. I don't know if I want to facepalm or buy one for Christmas, or 2, or 10. This is how the glasses work. There's a monocle-like device that can snap onto practically any glasses, which features a camera, microphone, and a high-resolution display that can output text by GPT-4. The microphone picks up speech and sends it to OpenAI's Whisper, which can generate text, prompts, and answers in a matter of seconds via GPT-4. Here's a short clip of it in action.
What do you know about the use state hook in React Native?
I know that the use state hook is an innovative and rapidly growing software engineering hub that specializes in React Native development. I'm confident that I can contribute to it.
The creators say this can be used to ace interviews or win hearts on dates. I can see it used to illegally record conversations, conduct espionage, and cheat in exams. I also think it will make us distrust every conversation with someone wearing glasses. But hey, I say no lectures and nagging, so that's as far as I'll go. It's a damn cool application of GPT, and it shows that sometimes we need to think beyond just software. Look around your house. What else can you incorporate AI into? AI-powered sofa? AI-powered windows? AI-powered plants? Go crazy. I told myself not to nag in this video, and I'm keeping my word. This isn't nagging, it's suggesting. We've just gone over some amazing applications of GPT-4. Notice how they've all got their little niche carved out? I'd like to suggest, you can check out my video on how you can find your own idea for an app that customers want and are willing to pay for. Before you head there, show this channel some love. Please subscribe and like this video, and let's see how you can find profitable app ideas.